stuff down here on the bed. I'll show you guys. So I've got everything in here. Sorry. I've got a mirror in here. I also have my eyelash curler, an eyebrow pencil, a color corrector, my contour, and like a little quad, eyeshadow quad in here, and a bronzer. Off. AC just turned on, but I went and turned it off. Loving the Makeup by Mario foundation, and this is in the color, or in the shade 11N, and I feel like it's like the perfect shade for me. And sometimes I do mix it with I think it's my Too Faced foundation, but that one is a little dark for me at the moment because I got that one in the summertime. On my red areas first. And then dispersing everything out. usually if I'm blending this with my hands, this should be like, it would be enough. But with the Beauty Blender, I feel like it just, it gets, it like sucks up all of the makeup. Moisturizer. So let me just grab that. Thank you. sticks that just like blend out really nice and looks like and look pretty natural, just let me know, because after this I do want to purchase something different. Let's get started. And I usually use start behind my ear here and then bring it down, and I like to go underneath the actual jaw instead of like on top of it. And then blend the rest out. Thank you. nightmares that I have when I take melatonin. What else do we talk about? I don't know. I honestly don't know what I talked about at all. Oh, we also talked about my side business that I have with my boyfriend. We make home decor, and what else did we talk about? I don't know, but it was so much fun. But okay, I think that is enough contour. It's a little warm, but I also noticed with like applying this contour over top of the makeup, I feel like it tends to, what's it called? Pick up the foundation, and you start to see like the redness on my skin. So that's why I like doing the underpainting method, because it doesn't really pick up the foundation. Fix it with some color corrector / concealer that I make. Okay, I think that's pretty blended. I've always wanted to try that contour technique where they like bring it down and then this way, and then they blend downwards, and so that way it just like gives you that shadow here. So I'm gonna try that out, because like, why not? slightly. Moisturizer, that way it's not like so thick underneath my eyes. And I do like one pump. Very ouch. I got a cramp. Just like a small pump. And I like to use this e.l.f. color corrector. It's the like that much. lashes down. So I mainly just like to curl them. But I feel like I should do it for the video. I'll do it for you guys. This is the mascara that I use. It is by just makes it look a lot more natural, but the tint is still on there. Yeah, just like okay. It matches this ear. I don't know why this ear is so red. It's probably the drink. Let me add some foundation to it. And I'm gonna be using this brush. I have like three of these brushes. I have one for powder, just to like set my entire face with it. And then I have this one for foundation, because this is initially a foundation brush. It's the e.l.f. Ultimate Blending Brush, but it's a foundation brush. So I'm just gonna apply that onto my ear so it's not so red. Okay, I think that looks a little better. Shoot. somebody over there, they sent me like a whole bunch of girls and guys that were available to shoot for the entire week that I was there. And I didn't know like any makeup artists over there, so I was like, I guess I'll do their makeup and it'll just be like a simple glam, just like super simple. And I'm pretty sure they knew how to do their own makeup too, but I was just like freaking out. I was like, I need to go to like, I didn't even know if they had like a Sephora or anything. So we went to like this random spot in Reykjavik. I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce it, but it's like the main city by the airport. It's like 40 minutes away from the airport, I believe, or 30 minutes. And I went into like the shop where they had like a whole bunch of makeup, and I bought this and a bunch of other things, like I told you guys. And this palette specifically was like $40, so I ended up spending like, I think I spent like $120 or something like that. But yeah, I thought that was so crazy, but I'm like, who cares? And then also in the hotel, I was practicing on Brian, sorry. I was practicing on my boyfriend, the look that I wanted. And it wasn't until we were in the hotel where we were on Instagram looking for makeup artists based in Iceland, well, based in the city that we're at. And we found this amazing girl. She was so funny. She was like amazing. She literally saved the entire shoot because she did the makeup for the model and she was great. She also spoke English. And then when we went the second time, we ended up booking her again. And again, it was like the best experience. But yeah, that's the story of this eyeshadow quad. But I'm gonna start off with this shade here. And I'm just gonna apply a little bit because I don't normally do this. I'm just gonna apply a little bit on the eyes just to create some definition with the shade. Okay, that's maybe a little too much. I'm gonna add a little bit over here. And then I'm gonna blend that up. You blend it out into your eyebrow and just like wing it out, it tends to look a lot more natural instead of like eyeshadow, but it just still creates that definition. So I'm just gonna blend this other side here. That now it's like right notice that on the outer corner, just like here, yeah, just to like get that definition. Another thing I like to make sure is that I'm looking forward and not like down or like this, because I feel like you look at people like this. I don't know how to explain. You look at people like straightforward with your eyes. You don't look at them like this, and you don't look at people like this. So if you do your makeup like this, you're gonna blend everything into the crease here. But then once you look forward, everything is like hidden. Especially if you have like, I guess, hooded eyes, or I don't know. I feel like it just makes sense to me in that way. So when I do people's makeup, I always like them to look straight at me. Yeah. So I'm just gonna do a little bit of that just to add some dimension, not too much. I don't know, I feel like I'm comfortable with this. Like if I were to go out like this, I wouldn't feel uncomfortable. But if I did do like a whole like cut crease and like glitter in the middle, I wouldn't be as comfortable. But that's just me. But I feel like that looks pretty natural. I might bring some of that color underneath my eyes, because I feel like there's like that disconnect. But I'm gonna do the other eye right now. Honestly, it's not that light. I feel like it's the light that's washing out my mustache. But just to go with the eyebrows, I'm gonna fill this in. Yeah, I feel like the eyebrows are darker than my mustache. Little insulation on the sides here, so I'm gonna blind that. I can't wait to set this. I feel like it's so shiny. Some on my upper lip just to add that. redness. I'm so used to covering up the redness. Like that. face, I'll go in with the brush. Do my other eye. Powder all the way to like my brows and on the eye. English on there. But it's not bad. I feel like it looks pretty good. What do you guys think? So much. Here's a heart, and here's another.